Hello students, today I am going to teach you the new software, and that is new software of Adobe After Effects. It is especially for the motion graphics and visual effect purpose. So in today's lesson I am going to teach you the interface of the Adobe After Effects, how it is worked and what to do with the softwares. So I am just opening the software, and this is the software you are seeing. So when you open the software, then you can see that this is the default. Already untitled project.aap, this is the default project always when it opens. So everything, every work in the After Effects is done in the form of composition. It's just like a sequence in Adobe Premiere. So I think there's not too much difference with the sequence. So first of all, if I have to create anything, I have to work in composition. Before going into the composition, we need to know about the interface of the After Effect. So this is the default workspace when you open the After Effect. This is called project area, where you can import your elements or images, videos, music. This is the timeline area where you can work on animations and keyframes. This is the composition area where you can see the what animation is going through. This is the screen basically. This is the menu bar, drop down menus are here, and this is the toolbar. These are called the property windows. So let's suppose take any composition. So now it will more clear for you. Now you see this screen, this is called composition screen, this is project area. Now timeline is visible, so you can do any kind of animations in this area. And this is the property panel, you can change the property of anything like text or anything. You can also on off the property according to your need from the Windows menu. So next thing I am going to discuss is that is the workspace. When you go into workspace, you can see the lot of workspace are here, the animation, effect, minimal, motion tracking, and default is a standard. So workspace is basically kind of precepts of the working environment. So suppose you are working for the animation, then you can click the animation workspace, so your software environment will be adjust according to that. If you want to work for anything other like effects and text, then you may change the other kind of workspace. If you want to continue with your own workspace, then you can also create your workspace. So go in Window, and suppose you are working with effects, then in this kind of workspace. But if I need to create my own workspace, then suppose I don't want this align wiggler, I want character in my workspace, I want tracker in my workspace. So you can save it as a new workspace, that is new workspace, and save it. Tracking one. Okay. So anytime if you want to work in that, you can switch to another workspace. If you want to go, which I have created, that is tracking one. So again you switch them. So this is helpful for those artists who are working on some specific projects and they need some specific properties, and according to that properties you can fix your environment, you can manage your software environment. So that's the workspace management basically. Now let's jump on the part of functionalities of the After Effect, how it works. So basically now I am talking about the compositions part. So how to take new composition, how you have to handle with the composition, how you have to change the setting of the composition, and then we'll talk about the basic transform properties. So for the take any new composition, it's very simple, press Ctrl N, or you can go in composition panel, just click on the new composition. When you click on the new composition, you can see this kind of a screen will be appear, this dialog box window, and in this dialog box, first of all, you can see the name of the composition, and you can give this name to the composition. So suppose I am giving the my name of the this composition first FIRST. So it's good to give the naming to all the composition, because when you work in industry, the naming convention is very important. When if you talk about the terms of number of files, because in the production houses, in the movies, a lot of the compositions you have to work. So naming convention is good to remember, good to rework or any kind of modification. So that is completely professional way to handle with the compositions. So I have given the name, composition name first. Then I have to give in the presets area. And this is the presets means already defined some sizes, because for the video we have to decide what will be the size. Basically size means in terms of the length and width. So you have to decide. So a lot of the presets are given for that. And as we know, the broadcasting systems work in India in the PAL. Lot of the broadcasting systems, two types basically, majorly PAL and NTSC. So you can also select the PAL D1DB. So you can see the width 720, 576 pixel. You can modify this after clicking and increasing. So that is also called customization of this, and you can select the presets. So I have taken this PAL D1. So all thing set will be according this, the frame rate and everything. Now jump on the time code. You can see the where the from where the animation will start. So it will start from the 00, and where the animation will end, you have to give the timing. So suppose we have to make the 10 second of animation, then you have to fill the 10 second in this part. So already I filled the 10 second. Just click the OK. So now the first composition is visible here, and the timeline is also active, and this is my screen. So that's the working with the new composition. So suppose I have to work on a layer, kind of layer. So I have to go in layer and take new layer. So these all are list of the layers. You can take text as a layer. You can take solid color, plain color, light camera, different. There is another way also. You can just right click new and just take solid layer. Okay. So this is the another way. So I will discuss about the transform properties, how we deal with the layer, how we have to do the animations, about the keyframes in our next tutorial. So till then, happy reading. Thank you.